It is only a few minutes past 9, and as expected, this place is packed full. The number of people who couldn't get tickets to get in, and they're waiting outside. The general and the other top officials of the APC are not yet here, but I think they're about moving, they're about coming in, I don't know. But you know, like it's been said, or like we saw on social media, that the media spokesperson for the Good Luck Jonathan, or for the PDP media campaign, has hired some youths to, you know, come here and demonstrate. As is expected, they are all here. And you know, I actually spoke to some of them before I did this video. I just realized that they are actually Nigerians who are struggling here. Like someone mentioned that some of them are actually, I'm talking about the ladies now, pardon me, and the red light district back here. Some of these youths are actually unkempt. I'm sorry, but I really have to say that because I drew close to some of them and they were obviously struggling. I'm talking about, you know, like their body odors, like I could feel it oozing out. And I wouldn't blame them if they come together to do a thing like this, because they actually need the money. I mean, I'm not happy saying this, but you know, it is what I observed, and I just have to say it the way, you know, I see it. It is sad that in a place as posh like this, with a number of diplomats from across the world, Nigerians should be doing this, spiting ourselves, destroying our names. Haven't we done enough damage to our country already than to now have youths come to a place like this and, you know, destroying the name of the country? I mean, doing so much damage about them. Look at them. I'm gonna give you a closer view of what I'm talking about. Hi, how are you doing? I spoke to you earlier on. Please, I want you to tell me why you're doing this.
Because we don't want dictatorship in Nigeria anymore.
Why? What do you know about the general?
The general Buhari?
Yes.
I just heard about him from people that he's not a good leader or something.
You only heard from people. Have you done your studies about him?
What is that?
Have you done your studies about him?
No, not at all.
No. But how did you come about this demonstration?
Well, I was told. I don't know what to say. I'm not prepared for this interview.
Okay, let me speak to my sister. How are you doing, darling? What's your name? Okay, tell me why you're doing this demonstration. You don't really know. Why don't you know?
Is it because of voting?
Because of voting. What do you believe in? You're not Nigerian.
I am Nigerian, but I'm...
Where are you from in Nigeria?
Yoruba.
You're Yoruba.
So I don't really know anything much about...
You don't know much about... About politics. Okay, so tell me what you're doing here then.
I came here to, you know, support.
Support who? You can talk to me. I'm your friend. I'm Nigerian. I'm from Edo State.
It's Good Luck Jonathan that we came to support.
You came to support Good Luck Jonathan. Yeah. Why are you supporting Jonathan?
I don't know.
You don't know why you're supporting him. So why are you against Buhari?
Oh, I'm not against anyone. Like, I'm not against anyone.
Okay, but why are you here for this demonstration?
I don't really know.
Okay then, you don't know why.
That's fine.
Okay. The girls I was going to speak with earlier on, they've actually moved. Hello, darling. Can we speak? How are you doing?
Yeah, I'm alright.
Can you tell us about this demonstration?
I don't really know what to speak.
You don't want to speak to me?
No.
Why don't you want to speak?
No. What part of you is there?
No. I'm a freelance.
Hello.
Sweetheart, can you speak with me, please? I want you to tell me about this demonstration.
I don't know what to say. I don't really know.
Why are you doing this? Why are you doing it for your president? But why are you doing this against General Buhari?
Omaru Diko, we need answers.
Okay, do you want to
We need answers, Omaru Diko.
Okay.
We need answers.
Okay. So you could see that quite a number of them are actually avoiding me. They actually have no idea why they are doing this demonstration. And it's actually sad. And like it was rumored, I would like to use that word, that they were paid to do a thing like this. It is quite obvious that they were actually paid.
Excuse me, these are students.
Like this.
They can only work for a few hours a week. Okay. As a matter of fact, I can understand or relate to their sentiment. Okay. The reason why being not in their interest, for the fact that they need to put food on their table, okay, they have to do this.
So they have to do
this. They have to do this. Don't blame them. They are just a victim of the same system that have been there training us in the last 6 years.
Okay.
Sorry, poor students. These are students. And these are international students.
Okay, you know what I'm going to do? This is the much I'll be able to take for the moment, but I'm going to come back and do more interviews, speak to more people, find out what they feel about this, because this is embarrassing to the nation. But notwithstanding, the general is going to be here soon. He's going to march in there. The conference is going to hold. When we come back, we'll see if we'll be able to, of course, talk with him. And like I said, do you want to say something?
One more thing I would like to say. You can imagine the same very youth,
yes,
general is trying to speak for,
yes,
are there masquerading. Good luck, Jonathan. This is just frustrating.
It's sad indeed. It's sad. Okay, people. Thank you. I'm going to round this up now.